So have you been listening to us for a while? You know about vibration? Pretty much. You understand that law of attraction is the engine that manages all of this? And that it is tuned to vibrational frequencies? Do you understand that everything has a vibrational frequency? Do you understand that your manifestations that will soon manifest have vibrational frequencies? And that if before it manifests, you achieve vibrational harmony with the frequency of it, then it comes to you faster. Do you understand that abundance has a vibrational frequency? Yeah? And can you imagine what it feels like? What would the vibrational frequency of abundance feel like if you were going to put words to it? It would feel like ease. It would feel like freedom to choose, certainly. It would feel like eagerness. It would feel like clarity. The vibration of abundance feels like fresh air. It feels like clear path. It feels unlimited. It feels always flowing. It feels abundant, 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 meaning never ending, always flowing. It doesn't feel pinched off, and it doesn't feel like jealousy, and it doesn't feel like worry, and it doesn't feel like fear. It feels like fun. It feels like sureness. It feels like certainty. So let's say that you're standing in a what isness of less abundance than you want. If you can take your attention away from your perceived manifestation of not enough, and you can focus upon something else that feels like fun or something else that feels unlimited. In other words, you can use subjects other than the subject of money, which may feel like not enough every time you think about it. You can focus upon other things that feel like fun, that feel unlimited, that feel like clarity, that feel like fresh air. You can practice the seed vibration of abundance by staying off the subject if the subject calls something different from you. You see what we're talking about? A while back we said, if you're working on abundance, if abundance is something that is important to you, then take money out of the equation. Because there is so much abundance that is abundantly around you that you can tune yourself to the frequency of that. What's something else you want? Usually it falls into a handful of categories. You want money. You want a lover. You want someplace really great to live. You want a body that feels good. So let's say that your intent is for a lover who isn't there. A lover, what does a lover feel like? What does it feel like? What does being in love, what does a lover feel like? What's it feel like?
High.
Feels happy, feels high, feels
loving, appreciation,
pretty damn good. Feels like well-being, feels like homecoming, feels like security, feels like appreciation, feels like being appreciated, feels effortless, feels like ease, feels natural, feels like desire. In other words, if you can get to the general vibrational reason behind what you want, which is what, why do I want it? The question, why do I want this thing, will bring to you. Then you can, we know you can begin practicing the vibration of the manifestation that is coming. Now, here's the thing that we know that often you don't know that we so want you to know. And that is that everything you've asked for is coming. And the only question is, how long are you going to keep yourself from it? Do you understand that there is abundance immeasurable, abundance not recognizable by most of you, abundance not yet experienced, let's just put it that way, by most of you, abundance for you, vibrationally queued up, and that all you've got to do, all you've got to do, the only thing you've got to do is to practice the vibration of it. And it makes its way to you in so many different life-giving, fun ways. But you got to practice the vibration of it. And that's what trips humans up. We love you very much. You know what's coming next. But you don't, for the most part, practice the vibration of what's in your vortex. You practice the vibration of what's already manifested. And what's already manifest is a puny comparison to what's available to you. Do you have any idea how many experiences you have called to you that you're not allowing to flow with the ease that is possible? And do you know the one reason why you're not allowing these things, experiences, people, places, events, circumstances, dollars to flow to you in the way that you want? It's because you are fixated on the observation of what is, and you are letting the absence of what you want in your what isness dominate your vibration, set up a vibrational field that holds it apart. So you've got this pull, push, pull, push, pull, push thing going on. I want it, but I want it now, and I want it yesterday, and I want it so much, and the not having of it has me upset. That's basically what your vibration, most of you, we love you so much. But we thought you might like to start this new year off knowing how to create your own reality. Because nobody else is creating your own reality, you see. That's why it's called your own reality. Your own reality. You are the creator of your own reality, which means you are the vibrator of your own beingness, which means you are the thinker of your own thoughts. You are the perceiver of your own world. You are the attractor of your own experience. You are the maker of your own life. You are the uplifter of your own being. You are the magnificent genius creator who came into this physical body with the express intent of mixing it up, of looking around, of identifying what you want, of achieving vibrational harmony with it, and then taking glory, watching with reverence and appreciation and rambunctious zest for life, watching the components of your creation come into place one by one to, in some cases, surprise you, and in every case, delight you to the power and the clarity and the worthiness and the goodness and the readiness and the bigness of that which is you.